Hello and welcome back to Particular Pixels. I'm Xiaoling, and in this episode of the Overwatch Report, I wanted to give you guys a brief overview of the in-game options for the Overwatch beta. I'm sure many of you are interested to see what kind of graphical settings are available, and perhaps some of you are interested in seeing the tutorial. So first up, we can see we have the mouse settings, so with sensitivity and invert look, everything you would expect to have. We have gamepad settings for those of you who want to use gamepads. And then under key bindings, we have everything you would expect to find: movement keys, weapons and ability settings, and communication. Now, these communication settings are to get your character to communicate in team fights and stuff if you don't want to use the actual voice chat in the game, so that you can at least communicate with your teammates when you need healing or you need backup or when people should group up and all this kind of thing. So that's all built in here. Also, you can see that many of the abilities have already got gamepad mapping to them, so you don't have to do too much of that unless you aren't happy with the default controls, which is always good to see. And now getting on to the part that most of you are probably interested in seeing, the video options. So starting up here at the top, we can see we have windowed mode, full screen windowed, windowed mode and borderless windowed. We have a plethora of resolution options to choose from. So it seems to cater to a wide variety of resolutions as you would expect it to. There's a field of view slider as well, which is great. The only complaint that I have with this field of view slider is, well, exactly that. It's just a slider. There's no indication of what the actual field of view is. So I think it would be nice if they actually put a number in here so you had an idea of what the field of view was, depending on where you put the actual slider. Just below that, we have preferred aspect ratio. So you can select 16:9 or 16:10. We've got gamma adjustment. Full screen display chooses which of your monitors, if you have more than one, which of the monitors is going to be the main monitor for the game. Or here we have best match to the resolution settings that you have chosen. Then we've got VSync, triple buffering, and for some reason limit to 30 frames a second if you so desire. Show stats, I'm assuming that is going to be connected to showing the frame rate of the game when you are playing. Then moving down, we have graphics quality, and of course we have the overall graphic quality setting here. This is sort of a preset, so you can see if I select low, it changes all these options below. I'm currently running on Epic. I'm using 970 SLIs in this computer, but you can customize it. You don't have to use these presets. If you want to change each individual setting, you can just go ahead and set them to whatever it is that you prefer, so that it runs as best it will on your computer. There are a fair amount of settings to choose from here. We have fog details and shadow details and model details and reflection qualities, local reflections, ambient occlusion and all that, texture quality, texture filtering, dynamic reflections. Now, something I noticed that was quite odd was translucent shadow detail. If I put it on ultra, you can see here, it puts translucent shadow detail to high, but the moment I put it onto epic, it just disappears. So I don't know if there is actually a setting in here somewhere that's not displayed. Like, there's one higher than high. I'm not entirely sure. We have effects detail, and we have anti-aliasing quality going all the way from normal to ultra. I think I would have preferred this to be an actual number, whether it was 2x, 4x, 8x anti-aliasing, and what kind of anti-aliasing it, we don't know. So perhaps it would be nice if they actually mentioned that. But then again, most of Blizzard's other games don't. They just have anti-aliasing quality as well. You know, StarCraft, Diablo, Heroes of the Storm, whatnot. So it's not the worst of things. The other thing is simple ambient light. This is disabled at the moment. This is obviously going to be a simpler version of the lighting in the scenes, in the levels, and will improve performance. So you'll notice that if I put the game on low detail, it enables simple ambient light. That's pretty much it. I think that the settings are decent. They're everything you would expect from a good quality game on the PC. Nothing seems to be missing, so that's all good to see. And on a side note, the performance is superb. You know, the game doesn't drop below 60 frames a second. It runs buttery smooth all the time, even when things get really, really chaotic on the screen. So that's always good to know. If we head back down, we have the sound options as well. So we can see we can enable or disable sound. We have game volume and voice chat volume. Unfortunately, I don't see a music slider in here. There is in-game music at the beginning and the ends of the levels. So I'm quite surprised that we don't have the option to adjust that volume. Not everyone wants the music to be as loud as others. So perhaps they will add this in when the game gets closer to release, hopefully. And then we have voice chat enabled. If you are wanting to chat with your teammates, team voice chat enabled, party voice chat enabled. Now, team voice chat is for when you are talking to people within your team in the game. Party is the voice chat's going to be, because you can create a party before you start a match. So this will be with your group of friends, if I can say that. And then push to talk enabled and profanity filter you can enable or disable according to what you want to see. But that's pretty much it for the option menu in the game. It's a lot of good options to see. A lot of customization is available, which is great. And now moving on to the next part, I wanted to show some of you guys the tutorial in the game. Now, I do want to say that there is a lot of talking in the tutorial. And I suppose for those of us who have played a lot of first-person shooters or just played a lot of games in general, it might seem kind of simple. But what I want to do is I'm going to go through the tutorial. I'm not going to say anything because, as I mentioned earlier, there is a lot of dialogue in the game. So I'm just going to play through the tutorial. It's not particularly long, from the beginning to the end, and record the whole thing so you guys can hear all the dialogue and basically see what it's all about. And I hope you enjoy. And I'll see you afterwards.
Hello, Soldier 76. This is Athena. I will be guiding you through the combat training program. Let's begin. First, look up at the dropship above you. Thank you. We'll need some assistance for the next part of the program. Tracer, if you would.
Hiya! Tracer here!
Now, use your controls to follow her.
Over here!
Excellent. Now find Tracer again.
Here I am!
Let's try that one more time. Then we can move on.
Up here!
Now, let's go over movement in Overwatch. You can move forwards and backwards in the direction you are looking. You can also move left and right. Excellent. Let's continue. Please follow Tracer as she moves around the hangar. Continue following Tracer. Tracer is moving again. Excellent. You seem to have the hang of it. You can also jump to clear small obstacles. Follow Tracer and jump up to the target range. Enter the target range and move to the highlighted area. Let's begin weapon training. First, let me put some things on your screen. You can see your portrait in the bottom left, Soldier 76. Your health is displayed to the right of your portrait. If your health reaches zero, you die. Try to keep that from happening. Your primary weapon is your heavy pulse rifle. I've set up a target for you in the range. Aim the crosshairs in the middle of the screen over the target, then fire. Nicely done. You can also hit the target up close with the butt of your rifle. Not all targets will be as easy to hit as this one. I am deploying some mobile training bots for you to destroy. Note the red outline around the robots. This means they are enemies. Damaging an enemy will display their current health. Yeah. Nice. Most weapons fire a limited amount of ammo before they need to be. Your weapon's current status is visible at the bottom right of the screen. When you run out of ammo, you will automatically reload. You can also manually reload. Just one round. Great work. That covers the basics of your weapon. The next phase of the training program will focus on your abilities. Your first ability is Sprint. Move forward, then activate Sprint to move even faster. Good. Your next ability is Biotic Field. To properly demonstrate it, I need to damage you slightly. This might sting. Now deploy a biotic field at your feet. Stand inside the circular field to heal. Note that you will have to wait a short time before using that ability again. This cooldown time is displayed over the ability icon. I see that you are ready to continue. Very well. Your next ability is Helix Rockets. Using it launches a volley of rockets in the direction you are aiming. The rockets explode on contact. I have prepared a set of targets for you. Damage the targets with your Helix Rockets, and we will move on. Note how the Helix Rockets damage targets near the point of impact. Now, let's discuss your ultimate ability. Tactical Visor. Ultimate abilities can change the course of a game. You must fully charge an ultimate ability before you can use it. The current charge level is displayed at the bottom of the screen. You charge your ultimate by dealing or taking damage. I'll summon some targets for you. Engage the training mix whenever you're ready. Your ultimate is 50% charge. Your ultimate is almost fully charged. Your tactical visor is charged. When it's active, aim in the direction of an enemy and open fire. Now, All targets destroyed. Nice work, Soldier 76. For the final phase of the training program, you'll capture an objective. Your current objective is indicated with a directional marker on your screen. Head through the open door and move to your objective. Control point objectives are clearly marked by a bright outline on the ground. To capture it, move inside the area. While you are within the area, you make progress towards capturing the objective. Current capture progress is displayed on your screen. If there are enemies in the area with you, capture progress is paused. You've captured the objective. Well done. There are times when you might want to switch heroes due to current combat conditions. Bring up the Hero Select screen to view all available characters. Let's try switching to Tracer. First, select Tracer from the list of heroes below. When you have a hero selected, you can view details about them. Now confirm your selection. Well done! You have completed your basic combat training.
Well, that was the tutorial for you guys to see. As I said, it wasn't particularly long. It does run you over all the basics of the game, so to get you up and running. It's not too complicated, the game itself. But there is a lot of learning to be had. Every character is very different and plays very differently. So depending on your preferred game style, you'll obviously gravitate towards one or other of the characters that are available in the game. But I'll be talking more about the game mechanics themselves in another video, and I'll be covering the heroes in another video as well. I'll make a series of videos dealing with each of the heroes in turn. But if you guys have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them in the section below. I've been Xiaoling, hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you next time.